Welcome to the show, everyone. I'm your host, Naima Abdullahi. We begin with the leaked Supreme Court draft ruling, the reversal of Roe versus Wade. So what does that mean for Black women in particular? That's tonight's top story.
A leak that sent shockwaves into the nation.
Huge breaking news tonight.
The fear of overturning an almost 50-year-old case sparked a debate among Black women who already felt unprotected within the health system.
I have two strikes. I'm Black and I am a woman. And now I barely have rights. I don't have rights to my own uterus.
Abortion is health care. Health care is a right.
They are life. They are people with a heart.
If overturned, 23 states would limit abortion access. 13 states with trigger laws would ban abortion immediately.
What had happened in Texas is there's no abortions and there's no exceptions from the 6 to 8 week mark when you can hear a heartbeat.
Deep breaths.
So this is when you start to feel something to pull it.
It basically allows the state of Mississippi to outlaw abortions at 15 weeks, which doesn't sound very radical to most folks when they hear that, because they think, oh, 15 weeks is a long time. But what this sets up is it allows every state to decide when you can get an abortion, if at all. And so that is why this is so dangerous.
The controversial development has led to an unraveling of its historic origins of abortion in the U.S.
I'm sure everybody has heard the story of Margaret Sanger. She created Planned Parenthood, and she was a eugenicist. She wanted to get rid of the quote-unquote Negro population.
We cannot go backwards.
Abortion pills are in our hands and we won't stop.
Get the f*** out of my heart!
Pro-life versus my body, my choice, a long-standing debate heating up once again as Black women are now speaking up on where they stand.
I believe that under the right Supreme Court, it will be overturned. I don't believe it's a civil rights issue. I really don't.
To all the Black women and girls who have had abortions and will have abortions, we have nothing to be ashamed of. We live in a society that has failed to legislate love and justice for us. So we deserve better. We demand better.
A lot of folks think that the right to have an abortion is just about the choice of whether or not to be a parent. That's not true, particularly for Black women.
These are my arms, my legs, my vagina, my body. You cannot tell, you should not have any say-so about what it is that we do with our bodies. I can't say what I really want to say on this mic.
I mean, statistically, according to all the information out there, we will be hit because, unfortunately, so many of us live below the poverty line and have inadequate health care.
After that, I remember being wheeled back to the operating room because I had to reopen my C-section and restitch it.
Well, maternal health is something that Serena Williams has talked about. It's something that is in the forefront because still too many Black women in America are dying as a result of poor maternal care.
Here to help us cut through the noise are social justice journalist Lisa Durden, attorney Lisa Luncheon, better known on TikTok as Legal Luncheon, and Mallory Fink from the Anti-Abortion Social Club. Thank you for joining us, ladies. Let's address the biggest misconception with this draft that's gaining national attention. Overturning Roe versus Wade would give states more authority instead of the federal government. Could this lead to women seeking dangerous options? Lisa, I want to start with you.
This kind of dangerous thing opens up a bunch of cans of worms. We have a law called Roe v. Wade. It's a law. Not only is it a law, but it is a woman's civil rights to be able to have agency over her body and be able to make those decisions. So what happens is when you take a woman's civil rights, you harm them. And this is what this is doing. It's problematic at best.
What does a post-Roe world look like to you?
A post-Roe world looks like getting dangerous abortions. Abortion's not going to end. And I think I want to piggyback off of a point that was made earlier in that contraception, right? Education. These are all much better ways to reduce abortion. And as a matter of fact, the national abortion rate has been reduced, right? What we see now, people always like to invoke the fact that Black women, right, receive the most abortions. Well, if we want to talk about that, let's talk about how dangerous it is for a Black woman to become pregnant and give birth in this country. Let's talk about how Black women are dying at a higher rate than our counterparts in giving birth. And if we want to talk about that, I think all of these are way better solutions versus outlawing abortion where this is going to take effect in the southern states where over half of the Black population resides. This is going to have a huge and disproportionate effect on women of color, on Black women specifically, because let's get specific. And what we're going to see is individuals who do have more money, they're going to be able to still get abortions and they will continue to get abortions.
Why do Black women have the most to lose if the law is overturned?
Well, Black women have the most to lose because we're losing already, right? And then I'm so sick of this discussion about uterus Olympics. I'm so sick of people trying to have our uteruses compete with each other. Yes, I feel like we should offer people who are victims of sexual violence those options, but all women should be afforded that, not the uterus Olympics, where this person's uterus had an issue because she was raped, but this person's birth control failed, so no, she can't do it. We know the facts, not my opinion, the facts, that there was a dangerous thing happening in this country long before Roe v. Wade, where women were still getting dangerous abortions, back alley abortions, dying and bleeding. They're going to do it anyway. So why not make this legal? Why not remain keeping it legal and make sure it's safe?
Quite frankly, I believe morality and logic is on our side. Because if we can say that life is important, if we say that we value life, we see that life begins at conception. So we understand and can protect that life in the mother. I understand and I have a lot of sympathy for people who are in those situations where they possibly are in poverty, where they're unable to provide for the children they already have. That's why I think it's so important for us to do things to be able to help those people. I don't think that the solution would be to eliminate another human.
There's so many different layers to this. The heartbeat law, which when a heartbeat is detected around 6 weeks, it makes it illegal in about 5 to 6 states. So what is your stance on this?
I believe that that life must be protected. I think that it is part of our duty, part of us standing up for the truth to protect it.
I think that the draft opinion was alarming on several fronts. I think there was definitely some allusion to Black births being aborted, population control. I've heard that. Again, I think if I was going to say one thing I agreed with, and there's very little I agreed with, what you said today, but if I was going to agree with one thing, I would say that there are extremists on both sides of the table. And I do want to say this as well. You've kept saying that your belief is that life begins at conception, but that is not a belief that everybody has, right? And we can't take that as just, fact. And you made that quote about the scientists. I have no reason to disbelieve what you say. So say I'm going to take that at face value. Still, you are imposing something on another individual based on your belief. And that's the problem.
When it comes to reproductive rights, what restrictions should there be? Mallory?
So this is probably going to be a very unpopular opinion. I do not think we should have abortion at all. I don't think there should be any exceptions. Once again, it goes back to this is a human being and the way someone is conceived is not their fault.
I was certainly concerned when you said that you believe that there are no exceptions, which I'm understanding to mean, even in terms of sexual assault and things of that nature. But I don't want to go that deep into that because my position is what we just stated, right? I don't think it should matter. I think if you want to have an abortion, you should be able to have an abortion, and that's that on that. What Roe versus Wade did, though, is that there was a limitation, and that was an attempt, in my view, to have a middle ground, right? You couldn't ban abortions up to a certain point, right? So if the woman wanted to have an abortion up to about, let's say 20 or so weeks, a woman was able to have that abortion. The conversation was between the doctor and the woman. That was a midpoint between, pro-choice and pro-lifers. Now we're seeing that if Roe versus Wade is overturned, these states, these more conservative states, these southern states, Georgia, like where I'm at, abortion is most certainly going to be banned. And I think that's the wrong way to go.
Thank you for your time and for your insight. We appreciate you as we dig deeper into this leaked draft that is sending shockwaves throughout the nation.